Perfect. If you're here, let me share with you the exact roadmap you need to follow to become an SEO expert and land your first client within few weeks. Yes, let me help you get ready. By the way, I know that when you have searched with this, how to become an SEO expert, you have no idea and you want to know everything from what is SEO, why is it in demand, why you should be choosing it as a career, what exactly you need to learn, how you can become an SEO expert, how you can build your portfolio, how can you get your first client or job. Don't worry, everything is going to be covered in this video. So what are we waiting for? Let's get this started. But first, let me introduce myself. If you're watching me for the very first time, I'm Prachi Gautam, 6 years experienced digital marketer, freelancer, and coach. And I've also switched my career from engineering to digital marketing. If you're watching this video as a completely newbie, I understand. I have been there where you are. So don't worry. SEO is very simple a skill and we will discuss everything in detail, how you need to get yourself ready to work with global brands and become a high-paid SEO marketer. Perfect. So let's get started. All right, so first let's understand what is SEO. SEO stands for Search Engine Optimization. Now let me help you break it down and make it simple for you. So search engine, what are the search engines? Any platform where you go and search for anything and you get the answer is known as search engine. Example, Google, Bing, Mozilla Firefox, Internet Explorer, Yahoo. These are all the search engines where we just go and whenever we type any query, let's say if you go right now on Google and search for how to make pizza at home, that is a search engine. And as a result, tons of blogs are written on pizza recipe. So that is the basically the job of a search engine. Now, what is optimization? Basically, as you know, the objective of using a search engine is to ask a question to Google or any other platform, and as a result, they give you the answers. If I'm talking about the search engine like Yahoo, Bing, Google, they usually give us the answer using website pages. So basically, these website pages are ranking because they are well optimized. So this is the term, search engine optimization. Optimization means editing your website page in a way that search engine could understand what your topic is about. And whenever a person search for anything related to that topic, it will help you to rank or become searchable by that person. Let's take a simple example. Suppose you have written a blog on pizza recipe. You do some editing in your page that you are making it clear to Google that, okay, your content is related to pizza recipe. So whenever someone search for how to make pizza at home, they should be able to find your page and read your blog or get into your website. So this is what is SEO. Now, in the basic sentences, I'm trying my best to help you understand, but it is much more about what are the techniques we follow. So we are going to come to that part. So first, it is clear what is SEO. It stands for search engine optimization that helps a website to rank better on search engine. Now, I completely understand that you need to understand why SEO is important, right? And why it's crucial for a business to make their website page SEO friendly, right? Cool. So first of all, let's understand that if whenever you publish a blog or any website page, if it is not SEO optimized, then algorithm couldn't understand what your content is about. So anyone who is searching for anything related to your product or services, they won't be able to find your page. Now it's like a dustbin. You have written a very beautiful blog or your business just have a very good products or services, but no one can find it online. So what is the meaning of having a specific business or product or services which no one can search for, which no one can find? That means if any business exists and if they do have a website and if they do not do SEO, no one would be able to find their product or services. So it's like you are a ghost. No one can see you. You exist, but no one can see you. So definitely those businesses who are not doing SEO in their website, they are not being searchable by their target audience, by their potential customers, and they are missing a lot of leads. And this is why companies couldn't take that risk. Their main objective is to become searchable. Let's take an example of Myntra. Whenever you search anything on Google like white t-shirt or any product item which is available on Myntra, usually you see their websites there, right? So they are not accidentally ranking there. They have edited their page in a way that whenever someone searches for white t-shirt or any specific product name, they want to rank there. So that is SEO, and businesses desperately need the SEO experts because they really want to rank on Google. Why businesses want to rank on search engine? We do have social media, but here are the reasons. First of all, when you rank on Google, you have global audience eyes on your website. It means you can reach globally. Second, it's organic method. SEO is completely natural. It's a zero investment process. If a website is ranking through SEO because of their quality content or product, they do not have to pay a single penny to search engine like Google or anything. So it's a completely zero investment process that any business would love to go for, right? And third is, on an average, in 1 second on Google, billions of people are using Google to find a product or services. Now imagine if you are having a website and if you do best SEO, then for a business, they can have a potential to reach to millions of their customers, millions of ideal audience, and it is definitely going to help them boost their sales and their business, right? So there is no doubt that SEO is the crucial thing for a businesses to exist and sustain and use SEO to help their business grow potentially. So definitely, if you're an SEO expert, you are that superhero for businesses. Now, when we understand that why SEO is important, I'm also going to display a couple of surveys in middle that you could understand with like why SEO marketers are in demand. But eventually, we also need to understand that how to become an SEO expert, because that's why you're here, right? So first of all, let's talk about what do you not need to become an SEO expert. A lot of people are having this myth that, okay, I need to do coding or I need to have knowledge about some languages, which is like a coding languages. No, it's nothing like that. I've done engineering, but I am from EC background and I do not know the C of coding. So you understand it, like even without a coding knowledge, you can do SEO. Yes, there are some basic tools and some basic methods are there, which we need to just leverage and do hands-on practice and you're good to go to become an SEO expert. But I'm gonna share with you in detailed manner. So let's talk about what do you need to become an SEO expert. First of all, you need to have knowledge about these four types of SEO. So first one, on-page SEO. Second, off-page SEO. Third, technical SEO. And fourth, local SEO. Let me share with you what they are in detailed manner. On-page SEO is basically whatever the edits that you do when you are publishing a page is known as on-page SEO. Example, if you're publishing a blog on how to make pizza, then definitely the moment you are publishing and all the edits or the kind of keywords that you stuff in the website, when you edit your snippets, when you edit the slug meta description and add the images and make all of your media and content SEO friendly, this process is known as on-page SEO. It means on the page, on the spot, when you are doing SEO during publishing process is known as on-page SEO. Cool. What are the things that is included inside on-page SEO? They are keyword research, keyword placement, snippet editing, doing alt texting of the images, making URL healthy, and a little bit of more steps. Cool. So this is on-page SEO. Now speaking about what is off-page SEO, it is just the opposite of on-page. So after you publish your content and all the activity that you do outside your website to get more traffic, do promotion, that is off-page SEO activity. Example, you have published a blog or just a product on your website. Now you would like to have more traffic. You would like to let people know that you have just uploaded it. So definitely you're going to do the promotion. So how could you do that? So in off-page SEO, there are a couple of different strategies we follow. First of all is doing backlinks. What is backlink? Whenever other website promote your link is known as backlink for you. So there are certain ways, like we can reach out to the websites to give us the link. Second, we can also do guest posting on Medium, LinkedIn, Quora, Reddit, and generate links by ourselves. Or you just promote your content on social media channels to let people know and drive your traffic to the website. So there are certain different ways. And next process we follow is also doing business listing. Example, there's a business, there's a specific coaching program, and they are registered themselves on Just Dial or Sulekha. So there are a lot of business listing websites also where we can register ourselves and generate link. So off-page SEO is about link building, link generation, promotion. That's what is included. Now, third type of SEO is known as technical SEO. Now, I know that you must be having faster heartbeat here because technical SEO, does it involve coding? No, nothing like that. Technical SEO is basically the health checkup of your website. Just like we go for a regular or routine checkup after 6 months to check out the deficiencies or to monitor our health. Usually, technical SEO is only like that. Like you use Google Search Console analytics to understand your traffic performance, to audit your website, to understand what are the errors are there in your website and fix them. And this is simple process. You need not to worry more about it. Yeah, there are a lot of factors to be considered, but the process is very, very simple. That is technical SEO. Now, the fourth type of SEO is known as local SEO. What is local SEO? Basically, Google Maps. Whenever you search for best restaurants near me or salon near me, whenever you are searching these queries on Google Map, you get a list of the businesses on your local area, right? Now, imagine if there is a specific local business, which is, let's say, a boutique, and they want to attract the local audience. For them, let's say this business is in Delhi. So for them, only the audience which are of their 5 kilometer, 10 kilometer area, they are only relevant for them. If they are ranking on Bangalore or Mumbai, it's not a relevant traffic for them. So for local businesses, we need to rank them on Google Maps. That is local SEO. And it's also a few step process. You need not to worry about it. So these are the four types of SEO: on page, off page, technical and local, that we need to learn. And it is going to be a hands-on training. And believe me, they are very easy. SEO sounds like, oh my God, so techy. But I also had that kind of feeling. But once I started implementing, once I started trying and learning it, it comes so naturally to me. And it's very easy. Anyone can do it, even 12 past student. Now, let's move ahead to how you can learn this SEO. So I have basically created a basic to advanced level SEO course where you will learn everything from on-page, off-page, technical, local, not just a binge watch video, but with a practical implementation. And you know what? SEO is like a mathematics. You cannot just watch and think like, okay, I know it, but you need to practice it. Now, I know that you must be having this concern that SEO is being done on a website. Now, if you do not have one, how are you going to do that? How are you going to practice SEO? Now, here's the game. You can basically build your website for free on CMS websites like Wix or WordPress, even if you do not know coding. It's just like using Canva. That's what I teach to my students. I really want them to not just learn it while watching the video, but practically implement it. So I usually give them assistance on how they can make a website on Wix or WordPress, which is entirely very free and easy. It's very user-friendly. You just need to follow a couple of steps and you will be able to create your own website, and where you can practice on-page SEO, you can practice off-page, you can practice technical, and also you can build your own Google My Business profile as a digital marketer, as an SEO expert, as a freelancer, and make yourself searchable in your local audience, in the local area. So this is how we can practice SEO. Now the point is, definitely you can check out the course that I have created just in case if you would like to learn with very simple steps, with practical examples, tons of templates and hands-on training, then you are invited. Anyway, I'm not here to promote, just to now get into the next step, how you can build your portfolio as an SEO expert. Being a fresher, you do not have a website. But the point is, whenever a prospect or a client is hiring you, they would like to check whether you have done it for a previous client, whether you have done SEO on a specific website or not. Because you know what, it is very obvious that no one would like to give their website to a rookie person, because if any step goes wrong, it could crash their website. So this risk is very high for a specific prospect. That's why they usually prefer someone who has done it before. So here's the thing, how you can make your portfolio. As I just mentioned, that as a freelance digital marketer or as a freelance SEO expert, you can make your own website on Wix, on WordPress, on Shopify, on Canva. There are so many of CMS platforms these days where you can just make your digital portfolio, speaking about your expertise, speaking about your page, about your services, about your USP, about your proposal, attaching your samples. This is how you can make your own website and practice SEO there. And I tell you, it's very important for you as an SEO expert to have a website, because you are offering a solution to someone, and if you are not using it, client will be like, what? If you're offering this, why are you not using it for yourself? Example, let's say if you're going to a dermatologist to treat your skin, and if that dermatologist is having a lot of skin problem, you'll be like, why this person, even after having the knowledge, is not treating himself or herself, right? Same like that, as an SEO expert, it's important for you to have a website, and we can do it for free. We can create it for free, and that is going to be a portfolio you can show it to a client. By the way, if you feel like, okay, this is my mock portfolio. It means this is a specific service which I have given to myself and portraying it to a prospect. Then here's a bonus tip I would like to give. If you want a real client experience, then you can also offer 14 days free trial service to two prospects or two clients and help them do on-page SEO. This way, you will be able to get the attach a real client sample work. If they like your work, they will hire you permanently or they can refer you somewhere, right? Just doing a free work for only two prospects in your entire life won't cost you anything, but it will only make your portfolio strong. So these are a couple of my advices on how you can become an SEO expert and everything you need to know about what is SEO, what are the types of SEO, how you can build your portfolio. Now what left is taking a responsibility to learning the proven strategy through which you are not just telling a client that, okay, I can do SEO for you, but you can commit a client that if I'm doing SEO for you, I'll make sure that you're getting a specific ranking or I'll help you index all your pages, some promising outcomes so that even a fresher, you can stand out because you're promising those results. And if you want to learn such incredible tips, which will be able to deliver great results to the prospect, then you are invited. As I have just mentioned that I've created a beginner to advanced level course, and to know more about it, to enroll, you can definitely click on the description box. Until then, you can keep on asking me all the questions that you're having related to SEO. I'll be answering all of them into these comment section. Cool? So enjoy, slay your freelancing, and don't forget to become an SEO expert because the businesses need you the most at this very moment in the market. All right, ciao for now. Thank you so much for watching, and hold on, don't forget to subscribe this channel because every Thursday I'm coming up with a new video. And by the way, if you really found this helpful, don't forget to like and comment. All right, perfect. See you in my next video. Till then.